5820. That's Juice Newton and the sweetest thing I've ever known, loving you. 58 degrees at WBAP. Let's check out the community calendar. Advanced aerobics classes start the first week of each month at the Central Y WCA in Dallas. You can call the Women's Y and begin your commitment to fitness. As we said, 58 degrees. ABC News will be coming along on the hour. Coming up right now, it's Earl Thomas Connolly. Your love's on the line, honey.
Siegel and Jetcopter 820 will have you laughing at Metroplex traffic weekday mornings and afternoons on WBAP 820 Fort Worth, Dallas.
From ABC News, I'm Joe Vaughn. General Motors has accused the federal government of making what was termed a one-sided and distorted analysis of reported brake problems on GM's front-wheel drive X cars. The company was responding to charges of a cover-up leveled against GM after documents were released by a court showing that GM employees were aware of brake problems on the cars before they were put on the market. Clarence Didlow is with Ralph Nader's Center for Auto Safety.
The magnitude of the cover-up is that General Motors had a task force looking into this. Prior to production of cars, their own engineers and the testing of them showed that the brakes locked up, that they put the cars into production, they continued to investigate it, try to come up with fixes all during the first model year the cars were out into the public, and not one word ever got out to the public about this.
In the wake of the release of the documents, GM announced recall Thursday of more than 479,000 cars, 350,000 of them the 1980 Model X cars suspected of having the brake problems. The company says it assumes about 100,000 cars will be found to have faulty brake valves in these replacements. I look forward to this.
Red Cross has the friendly face, the outstretched hand, the understanding heart. We're your neighbors, helping people help themselves to a healthier life. When you need a helping hand, Red Cross is there. If you're old, we'll show you how to feel young again. If you're young, we'll teach you how to stay that way. And if you're working hard, Red Cross can keep the job from getting the best of you. We'll help you make it on your own.
Like a bridge over troubled water.
American Red Cross. We'll help. Will you?
Like a bridge over troubled water. I will ease your mind.
The governments of the U.S. and Italy are still firmly linked in disarmament talks with the Soviets. White House Thursday, President Reagan and Italy's Prime Minister Bettino Craxi emerged from 2 hours of private talks to reaffirm Italy's support for a plan to station new U.S. missiles in Europe, unless there's an agreement in the arms reduction talks underway in Geneva. As expected, the House voted Thursday to cut off covert funding through the CIA for anti-government rebels in Nicaragua. But the House voted once before to stop helping the Nicaraguan rebels. That was in July. As then, it's expected the Republican-controlled Senate will block the cutoff move and permit the funding to continue. When Americans argue over why they buy U.S. or Japanese products, is it only a question of quality, or is attitude more of a factor? For 2 weeks now, ABC's Irv Chapman has been examining the impact of U.S.-Japanese competition on American industry. Here's his final report.
John Huffman worked for a number of local manufacturing companies before he became a manager at a new motorcycle and auto plant in Marysville, Ohio.
I've seen that too many times when the pressure's up and sales are going good, they say people want these, they want them bad, go ahead and push them out, we can fix it in the field or we can fix it later.
That is not the philosophy at the new plant, which makes Hondas. Professor Robert Cole, who keeps tabs on the auto industry at the University of Michigan, is impressed with the competitive quality improvements made by Ford, GM, and Chrysler, but...
Particularly in some of these industries like auto that start coming back now, when you get a lot of pressure on the factory manager to get the cars out the door because they can't keep up in the dealer showrooms, that's when quality tends to fall off.
American companies are only beginning to reacquire their track record for quality, and it takes time to persuade the consumer that made in USA is as reliable as made in Japan. The Japanese, too, are improving all the while. Irv Chapman, ABC News.
A federal trial jury in New York City has convicted former CIA agent Edwin Wilson of attempting to murder two federal prosecutors, one of his business associates, and five witnesses who testified against Wilson in his two earlier convictions. This is ABC News. 29 officials who served in the Nixon administration have filed suit in an attempt to block release of 1.5 million pages of what are considered to be sensitive political documents from the Nixon White House. The Washington Post says the political materials are said to include candid assessments of various members of Congress and other officials and communications between Nixon and his top aides. Among those trying to block release are former Secretary of State Alexander Haig, one-time Nixon Press Secretary Ron Ziegler, and former speechwriter Patrick Buchanan. For the ABC Information Network, I'm Joe Vaughn.
And now with the Weather Center 820 forecast for Grand Prairie, Watauga, Wylie, and the rest of the Metroplex, Harold Taft.
Thank you, Don. The forecast for the Metroplex will call for cloudy and cool. You'll need a jacket in the morning. The winds will be out of the north about 15 miles an hour. The temperature will be down to about 55 or even a little cooler in some areas. Warm up no more than about the middle 60s during the day. Although I don't look for any major areas of rain, I would expect to see a little light, misty rain once in a while in the early morning hours. I think the clouds will break away to clear to partly cloudy on Saturday. Temperatures in the morning down about 48 and in the afternoon up to about 68. The winds will be northerly 10 to 15 miles an hour. That's the forecast. I'm Harold Taft, Weather Center 820.
57 degrees right now at WBAP 820.
We're on the road together with the U.S. One Trucking Show on WBAP Radio 820.
looks so lovey-dovey, lips as red as cherry berry wine. Now listen, Joe, I'm not a heel, but old buddy, let me tell you how I feel. She's a honey, she's a sugar pie. I'm warning you, I'm gonna try to steal her from you. This is where that friendship ends. I'm gonna keep that dolly for my own.